today's fast-moving world, enabled with technology, automation, artificial intelligence, blockchain, robotics, CFOs are no longer only finance function head. They are becoming more and more business partners, enabling revenue growth, enabling process efficiency, cost reduction, optimization, building in more and more efficiencies in the entire CFO back office operation, be it procure to pay, be it order to cash, be it record to report. The main focus is to look at the business KPIs, which can really help them build more efficient, data-driven, technology-driven, efficient operations, CFO back office operations. Let's look at P2P. What is the concerns of today's CFO? They are looking at the KPIs, which is either percentage of PO penetration, what is the indirect procurement sourced through e-catalog, what is the PO cycle time, what is the invoice cycle time, what is the invoice payment time, what is the turnaround time, what is the early payment discounts. And if we look at all these KPIs and the numbers given by experts and the analysts in the field, we will find the top performers way ahead in comparison to the people who are not adopting or embracing the technology to really build in, to really improve their process efficiencies. Let's look at few of the data. PO penetration today for the best in class is more than 75%, whereas people who are working still manually on the old working environment are doing only 35 or even less than that. Let's look at the indirect procurement. Even in the indirect procurement, your maverick spend is as high without the PO and the contract compliance as good as 65%. Your PO cycle time for the best in class is 5 days in comparison to the people who are at the bottom is even 35-40 days. And if my material is not coming in time, how come I'm going to produce, how can I'm going to deliver to the customer? So all these interdependent activities based on the KPIs, and let's look at the invoice cycle time. Invoice cycle time today for the best in class is 48 hours. Suppliers' payments are processed, booked after due payment terms in 48 hours time, not even that, even earlier, to take benefit of the early payment discount. Whereas the worst in class, it is going even beyond 65-70 days. So even in the P2P, entire P2P value chain, we have seen our partners, our customers getting benefit to the tune of $15 to $25 million for annualized saving if they really embrace technology to really transform their process with the help of automation, robotics, artificial intelligence, as well as analytics. Now let's go to the O2C or order to cash. What is the order fulfillment rate? Is my customer happy? Is he really getting the goods on the need by date? How many order cycle I'm running per day, per month, per week? Do we have this data? Are we enabling the complete process through automation or a transformation to really deliver what customer needs? Not only that, am I really increasing cost of my operation by having a very high inventory carrying cost, by having very few inventory cycle time or a turnaround time, by having very high aging in the receivables? Let's say, for example, 30% receivables from aging for more than 365 days. All this can be achieved today, and that is what CFO's main agenda is, to drive process efficiencies and automation to help them in a P2P and a O2C process, which again help them in a record to report process for their month end closing. 7 days month end closing days are passed, they're gone. Today, what they are looking is 2 to 3 day month end closing and closing of their books and reporting of the data. Today, if we really look at FP&A, planning and budgeting also, all this is possible with the help of automation, with the help of adoption of artificial intelligence, blockchain, and even robotics process automation for the complete business transformation, which really gives you true operational efficiency and really deliver the same or a better quality with the better productivity and a turnaround time to the end customers. So today, aim of the CFO is to be a catalyst in a business transformation through digital transformation and process automation.